fucking move that, man. No, you don't want it shot from up your nostrils, do you?
Well, I've taken numerous attempts.
Yeah, that's fine, spamming, just keep going.
Spamming out bullshit.
Yeah, just spat that bullshit out, boy.
Welcome to my kitchen. I'm Simon Hopkinson, the good cook. When I was two, I travelled the lands of Yorkshire, opened my own casserole farm. When I was 4 years old, I once made an omelette in under 4 seconds. I then travelled south to bitch about the gay bikers and their fishery skills, and also show off my prowess in the greenery yard. I rate myself pretty high in the chef's world. My carrot patch is one of the fluffiest around, and my plums reek deliciously.
Keep looking.
I love the Mediterranean. Such a rich smorgasbord of seductive foodery. This dish perfectly sums up my experiences as a young harlot working the beat along Tunisia's coast. I would in fact cook this very meal to my pimp most nights.
What are you doing? Yeah, I'm doing it.
As with all my recipes, I try to use only the finest British ingredients. Fortunately for me, God has blessed me with fertile soil, which allows me to grow and forage virtually anything I need. I also relish trowelling through my backyard yield and uncovering sensual nuggets of utter utopia. Like this barbarously wild Tanzanian bean nut.
And just walk past me.
God, now, a lot of you folks at home wouldn't have heard of this dish I'm about to explain. Because my friend Nancy recently went to Tanzania and brought it back with her, and it deeply saddens me that I haven't had a chance to cook it longer in my life. Tanzania is very famous for their green beans. However, if I'd have picked this out of my own garden... The good thing about the Tanzania green bean is it's just so succulent and moist and so juicy. Let me just tidy this. Clear a bit of space for the magic to happen. Right, what you first need to start off is you need to slice delicately down the shaft of the bean. Now most people cut it down the seam, but we're doing the shaft, slicing it. So don't take a very sharp knife, adult supervision is required.
You've got to get your hands in the
crease! Get right in there!
Ah!
Get in there nice and deep like.
Prepping the bean for sugarization. Here we go. One of the ingredients that really tops this dish off is the classic balsam vinegar. Ooh, that reeks deliciously.
Now just pop it in at gas mark 72 or 140 for all you fan-assisted lovers out there. It doesn't need much, 5 minutes tops. Don't be a cunt.
Right, the next stage in this cookery program is to crack the shit out of the egg. And even though most chefs say you need to, you don't include any of the shell. Yeah.
Once the 5 minutes are up, get her out the oven, boy. She's hot to trot.
Stir the egg.
There you are. It's cooked.
Remember, if you liked the video, fucking like it and subscribe to the YouTube channel. Jesus, come on. Please. Hit the hits.